Let us move on to the next panelist, Ms. Amelia Martin, representative UN Major Group for Children and Youth. Amelia, you have the floor.
Hi there. Thank you very much. Very happy to be here today. If I can, I'll share some slides. But I'm here today representing the United Nations Major Group for Children and Youth. So UNMGCY is the General Assembly mandated formal self-organized space for young people to engage in sustainable development processes at the UN. We've been actively engaged in the STI Forum for a number of years since it started in 2016 and are glad to see this kind of innovative approach taken today. So thank you for inviting us to take part in this exciting event. So today I'm going to present to you the Youth Initiative Platform. So this platform is live right now on our website. It's a very exciting initiative. It's a collection of youth-led and youth-focused initiatives from around the world that are responding to the effects of COVID-19 in terms of food and nutrition, education, medical responses, mental health, climate action, and more. So the overall goal of this platform is to promote youth initiatives while ensuring that they have a space to connect potentially to larger sources of funding or support. Several examples from the platform of the uses of science, technology, and innovation to respond to COVID-19, the use of games or animations to teach children about the virus, integrating virtual reality to address mental health concerns or provide therapy, using AI to identify cyberbullying, storing personal information in a centralized place using biometric data, lots of like very diverse initiatives on the platform. And they're all, you know, demonstrating different uses of STI to achieve the sustainable development goals. And given that they are responding to concerns in their region or communities that in many cases, larger organizations are not able to do right now, there are a lot of lessons that we can take from them to apply to the SDGs during and post COVID-19 to better reach populations. So in thinking of this question of using STIs to promote the sustainable development goals, there's a great capacity, obviously, to contribute to achieving goals, but there are always concerns of leaving communities behind or increasing digital divides. So there are always ways we can better utilize science, technology, and innovation to achieve the sustainable development goals and include more communities. For example, investing in broadband infrastructure to enable accessible internet, ensuring opportunities for lifelong skill development, incorporating indigenous or traditional and other knowledge systems, or considering nature-based solutions, for example. One example from the platform comes from SAP, or Solve a Problem Initiatives. So in line with this push towards online and distance learning, we're seeing they're developing online courses specifically to be used in a low internet setting. So instead of creating these high-tech, high interactive media courses, they're intentionally making a resource to rely on the least amount of internet and interactive features so accessible to a wider audience. So an STI solution, it doesn't necessarily need to be what we often think of as like high tech or outwardly very complex. Often a simpler or locally driven solution is more accessible. Another major outcome of the pandemic has been the very clear illustration of the necessity of promoting reliable sources of information, especially in terms of scientific innovations. Things like how the virus spreads or is contracted, potential treatments. There's a lot of contradictory information out there right now, and a real need for scientific and technology communities to work together to disseminate reliable information and disseminate information that's accessible to the public. So another example from the platform, No COVID-19, a group of 100 plus specialists from various fields were coming together to analyze news sources and share reliable, accessible information in a way that's understandable and locally relevant to the general public. So being able to communicate advances and innovations to the public and reach populations in a meaningful way is incredibly important, but it's also a team effort, especially right now. You know, in general, a lot of lessons can be taken from innovations that have arisen in response to COVID-19, especially when we're looking at youth initiatives that are reaching populations who were otherwise being left behind. These lessons learned, they should be carried forward to a post-COVID situation in working towards the sustainable development goals. COVID-19, it's caused a lot of serious disruptions around the world, but that doesn't mean we can't come back from this stronger and continue into the decade of action with new ideas and strategies to achieving the Sustainable Development Goals. We need to engage communities as co-creators rather than seeing them as just users. So UNMGCY and a community of youth initiatives will continue to contributing to these issues and these discussions throughout COVID-19 and as we look into a post-COVID-19 situation. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Amelia. Your last statement lessened from the COVID-19 experience will contribute to SDGs after COVID-19. It's great.